Having correlation between our predictor variables will not cause much issue during the building of a classification model, but will cause issues during the prediction time. Let us go through the list of potential predictor variables and use logic and correlation to remove duplicate or intercorrelated variables. If we look at the top two most associated variables to churn, they are total day in minutes and total day in charges. If we logically think about it, I would assume that the amount a person is charged on their phone bill for daytime calls would be directly related to how many minutes they talk during the day. On the left-hand side, we have a correlation matrix that visually represents the Pearson correlation values between the different variables. If we look at this, we can see the total day charge and the total day minutes has a very bright red block, meaning those variables are highly positively correlated. The values associated with it are also 1, meaning they are perfect positive correlators. To go even further, in the scatter plot on the right-hand side, that you can see as the total day minutes increases, the total day charges moves exactly in parallel with it. I would say that not only are these variables intercorrelated, but they are duplicate variables. With this being said, we should remove one of the variables since they are redundant, and having these duplicate fields will cause errors during the prediction time of the analysis. Looking at the list of potential predictor variables again, since the total day minutes field has a slightly greater association to churn than the total day charge field, I will keep that field and remove the total day charge field. Let us now look at the full heat plot of all the variables against each other. By looking at the full graph, I'm scoping out 3 things. 1, where are very red blocks? These very red blocks represent highly positively correlated variables. The second thing I'm looking for are very blue boxes, which represent highly negative correlation between variables. The third thing I'm looking for is little to no color. What this represents is little correlation between our variables. Now we'll observe variables that have very little correlation, since these are the variables that can be used as predictors together, since they have very little intercorrelation. If we look at the total international minutes versus the total evening minutes, we can see that the correlation between the two variables is very low at 0.02. In the scatter plot, we see no patterns and total randomness, meaning that the movement in one field does not affect the other. This is exactly what we are wanting in our predictor variables.